Okay, Zero, we got everything for the big episode 2 reveal party, right? Yeah, check that list,
yeah, let me double check before we check out.
Okay.
Hot dogs?
Hot dogs, check. Best sandwich ever.
Oh, so good. Yep. Salad?
Whatever.
I don't know what that is.
Yeah, check.
Chips, dip, yeah. What about the Fruit Loops?
My favorite, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. You know my favorite kind of Fruit Loop is the lime.
Really, lime?
Yeah.
See, I'm more of an orange guy myself.
Oh, really? Yeah. Guys?
Yeah. Yes, sir?
Yeah. They actually all taste the same.
It's morning at Jonathan Law.
And that means it's time for...
Technical Difficulties. Yes, it's the show that nitpicks everyday phrases.
So you don't have to.
I'm Mr. Roumeles.
I'm Mr. Zura.
Let's get technical.
Only on Eagle Eye Radio. Welcome back, everybody.
Hi.
Episode 2.
Hi, everyone.
Technical Difficulties.
What's up?
I'm Mr. Zura here with that wonderful co-host of mine, Mr. Roumeles.
It sounded like you were going to say something else.
No, I was just pausing for effect.
Also, I'm perfectly capable of introducing myself. Mr. Zura.
That's why I told you to let me do it.
It's good. It's good to be back, Mr. Zura. We had a little hiatus.
Just a little bit.
It's been crazy.
You know,
October is a crazy month. You have...
Holidays,
and stuff,
things.
Weaning of the days.
You know, though, the little break gave, it wasn't that long of a break, really, but
yeah.
our premiere episode is already up over 200 views, which makes it, I think, the fourth or fifth most viewed episode ever, and it's only been up for 2 weeks.
In the history of podcasts.
In the history of...
Not even...
Just our podcast.
Oh, okay. It's actually fairly low. In the grand scheme of things. So guys, get up on YouTube and listen.
Speaking of YouTube and playlists and podcasts.
Yes.
There's a bunch. I'm really excited. There's a bunch of new podcasts coming out.
Yes.
From our students here at Jonathan Law. Eagle Eye News. I think there's 4 or 5 new podcasts.
Yeah, I think Kalenich said, and they're starting
this
next
week. End of this week, I think.
Oh, beautiful. We're going to be debuting with them.
Yeah, together.
Well, welcome to the club, guys.
Yeah, really. I'm excited.
May the best podcast win.
Well, it's not a competition. It's just the kids are just trying
Kalenich said first prize was a free
pretty sure it's
trip.
Just an assignment that they're required to do. So.
No, come on. Well, competition is the spice of life. That's not at all a
it's
saying.
Not, that's not a thing. That's
maybe that's for another episode.
No, it's not going to be on an episode.
Oh, settled?
It's not a thing.
Lock it in. So we have a busy schedule today because viewers have been responding not only to the first episode but with other queries that they have.
Whoa. Yes.
Webster, not the word of the day.
No, not yet. We'll get to that.
Yeah.
The inbox was buzzing. You always correct me. I know it's not a hive of bees.
In them?
It's
okay.
I knew you were going there. It's
well,
not.
That's because you saw me forming the bees.
I saw the bee coming.
Oh, he must be going to bees.
We had a couple. We actually had two student inboxes, and then a very special.
One.
And no, it's not Mrs. Zura this time.
Oh.
We actually have another viewer
from
outside the school. So we'll save that for a minute.
Yeah.
The first one. Comes from a junior who it was actually sent via Twitter, so it's not like a formal email I have to read. But he basically said, "Guys, when do I use route or root, or what is the difference?"
If Google Earth or should I say Google Maps says finding you the fastest,
what do we say,
route or root?
Right.
Okay,
we're not talking about the roots of plants. That's easy because it's ROT.
Like a pathway.
A pathway or a router for a computer, like
but that's never a router.
No, right, it's not. Well, exactly. I know that's one of my set things.
Gotcha.
So router root. I mean,
all right. So
root.
I will say that I use different pronunciations at different times
yes.
for different situations. I cannot tell you what my law is, though. It just feels right
the
time.
We don't really. We don't go by Roumeles' law. I'm pretty sure there's
no.
Language,
I'm pretty sure that's the standard.
There's
of
language
law.
Language laws. Oh, although there really aren't, though. To cover you to come back to that.
No, there's not.
There's not. Like generally, like highways and like route 66, route 8. That is usually pronounced route.
Right. You wouldn't say route 66.
It doesn't
right?
have to be. But generally, people pronounce it route.
But if Columbus was searching for a route to the
doesn't sound
East Indies,
right?
No.
So I think the answer is there is officially no actual correct. They're both accepted.
They're both spelled
the
same.
If you go to our favorite language website, Webster's Dictionary, both pronunciations are acceptable. Some are more common in the vernacular.
Seems like,
not the Webster word of the day.
Seems like a bit of a cop-out, though, for them to say both are acceptable.
Well, I think it's just the dumb English language that they're both acceptable, but I think they're both acceptable. But route is more used for the highways and the passageway and such. Route is really just...
But in football terms, you could talk about a wide receiver making a
running
route.
Running a route, yep. And in sports reference, when you beat someone by a lot, you say you routed them.
Yeah.
So I think that's when it's used as route. There's no wrong answer, so we don't have to tell you what to do.
So we shouldn't have even brought this up.
Not at all. No. But I just didn't want to throw out the kid's tweet because they
very embarrassing.
He took the time to tweet at us, and it was the first one we've gotten this season, so I just wanted to address it. But really, it doesn't matter at all. So that was it.
So
technically, we wasted our time. Next up.
Yes.
A little bit of a fun. I don't know if you guys, I'm sure you heard the opening, but Mr. Roumeles and myself went to the grocery store.
We did. We went shopping for the big episode 2 reveal party.
Episode 2 reveal.
Which is going to consist of us eating
by ourselves.
Some treats, just hanging out in...
And solving someone's problem, though.
Room 191. Oh, always solving
there
problems.
There was another technical inbox.
Yes.
And the question was, are all Fruit Loops the same flavor, or are they different flavors? Because, as we alluded to... The lime green one and the orange one and the purple one, et cetera.
Right.
So we figured, I thought maybe, hey, let's do a little taste test on the air to see if we could tell.
Can we hear that you actually
have a little container of Fruit Loops here? I'm going to crack open fresh.
Can I have a Clementine while you're doing this?
Yeah, no, that was last season. We're past. Nope. I thought you only eat them at 9 o'clock.
I have one.
That's
right
not,
here.
But that's, no, we're it's a Fruit
it's
Loop
it's
test.
It's fine.
There's no way we're going to hear you opening that.
Wait.
He's literally peeling the Clementine into
the
microphone.
I got juice all over my pants.
That's what you get for peeling the Clementine into a microphone. So, now you stated in the opening, I won't stick my fingers into the cereal box. I'll let you pick out your green one that you said is your favorite.
I probably shouldn't have gotten the citrus taste into my mouth.
Or on your pants.
Not the taste test is wrong. All right, so I'm going to take my favorite, which is lime.
I'm going to go with the orange that I said.
Tastes like a Clementine.
Oh, we should have did the crunch louder into the microphone.
We'll get it in post.
Now take a different flavor.
Grape it is.
I'm going to go blue.
Those are exactly the same.
That
squeaky voiced checkout clerk was right.
I don't know why you got to insult the guy.
I don't like his voice.
Oh. Well,
it makes me uncomfortable.
I don't think people like our voices either, but...
Little.
So, folks, let me tell you why there's two easy answers to this Fruit Loop conundrum.
Yep.
One, if you read the ingredients on the box, there's no flavors.
None.
There's red coloring and yellow coloring and blue coloring.
It says artificial, right?
Yep, artificial. There's no lime flavor.
Any natural
or
colors?
Why would they put natural colors in this? Clearly just...
Flavors, I meant. Natural flavors.
Oh, I'm sorry. Nope. Oh, no. Well, it says natural fruit flavors, but in the literal ingredients, none of them are listed because they're not there. Also, by the way, for the record, the Kellogg's company who makes Fruit Loops has also come out and said, yeah, no, they're the same exact flavor. Oh. We just color them because kids like colors and it's fun. It's all in your mind. Although, side note, Mr. Roumeles, Trix actually do have different flavors. The kids' cereal, Trix.
Well, it depends on what kind of trick you're trying to play.
No. Just the Trix are for kids cereal box with the bunny.
Well, yeah, Trix. Kids play Trix all the time.
Yep. Nope. Not trick or treat. I think you're getting confused with Halloween. I see what happened.
Oh yeah. There. I'm sorry. That's next week's episode, most likely, right?
Oh yeah. Special Halloween episode. Wow. He's just turned into a werewolf.
It was just a sound effect. Getting a little ahead of yourself.
Sorry. I guess we have to have a big Halloween episode next week.
I can't believe you went that route.
Wow. Well done.
So Trix, T-R-I-X. T-X.
Just X.
T-I-R-X.
All right, that was just a side note. Forget it. Fruit Loops are all the same flavor. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise.
But so are Trix.
Not Trix. That's a trick.
Oh, those are...
Those are...
So Trix are
flavored.
The Trixy ones.
Now, if you want to get really confusing, just to make this more fun,
I'm
Skittles?
I'm already mortally confused.
Skittles?
Yes.
I don't know, because...
Who knows?
They are fragranced. Fragrance, is that a word?
No.
Nope. Well, it is right now. They smell different,
yes.
But they're actually the same flavor, although there's some argument that they're a tiny bit not the same flavor.
Okay.
But they're kind of the same flavor.
Now, what about M&M's?
Those are just chocolate.
I don't know.
Just sugar-coated chocolate.
You get those, that tangy fruit flavor?
Nope. You're thinking of sweet tarts?
What's the one where you, like, peel the orange? It's like a...
Clementine? You peel the orange?
I think I'm thinking of a Clementine again. I think I just put an M on it for my name, Matt.
We got to go back.
I got confused with an orange M&M. For the love of Pete.
We got to go back to the store.
We do.
Oh, man.
We're missing a lot here.
No, we're not. We're nailing everything.
Oh, okay.
So you have a technical inbox you wanted to share.
So, you know, ladies and gentlemen, most of our viewers / listeners are teenagers.
Not real.
And, yeah. They're imaginary. Most of our fan base, though, are teenagers. And one thing that's well known about teenagers is they're not particularly fans of being seen in public. Oh,
no.
Got a little crunchiness there.
Having some lime Fruit Loops.
It's pretty rude to eat on the air, but they're not fans of being seen with their parents in public, right? You know, teenagers are like, oh, mom,
mortified.
Hide behind the rack of clothes there.
Anything, yeah.
My friends are coming. Well, sure. I just want you to know, it's even more embarrassing when you are a professional educator, such as myself, and my mommy, Mrs. Roumeles, Mrs. Deborah Roumeles,
calling her out in the air,
makes her first radio appearance on my own radio show.
Wow.
And by appearance, I mean I'm going to read her technical inbox.
I thought she was here. She's not.
No,
not
I actually heard a knock on the door.
Oh, got nervous. Special guest.
So this is a technical inbox from my mom regarding last week's episode, 2 weeks ago's episode, of whether a hot dog is a sandwich or not.
Oh, for God's sakes.
So my mom likes to get the links of my show because, it's nice when your mom thinks you're the greatest thing in the world.
Yeah, that's great.
I need that ego, propped up once in a while.
Sure.
So she texts me back randomly. She clearly has listened to it. She doesn't even say, hi, sweetie. She doesn't say, hi, Matt.
Mm-hmm.
Or hi, Mr. Roumeles. She calls me Mr. Roumeles.
Yeah, my mom calls me Mr.
That's on my birth certificate. She says, hot dogs are not sandwiches.
Wow. Is that loud, like capital?
Yeah. Well, I just thought it was rude. Mom, it was rude. They exist in their own distinct category. A prime minister, president, czar, king, queen, etc. is each classified as a ruler, yet each differs according to culture, ordinances, and duties. Hot dogs primarily serve as the main course for barbecues. Its primary duty when you eat a peanut butter sandwich with potato salad, it's primary duty. Would you eat a peanut butter sandwich with potato salad? Question mark. Also, hot dogs may be eaten without bread. To conclude, while shopping, hot dogs are sold without buns. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Wow.
She didn't even say goodbye or goodnight, sweetie.
Upset. She is upset by this.
So that's my mom, guys. This show is tearing my family apart. And we're doing it for your entertainment.
I had, speaking of tearing families apart, last season we had my wife upset at me for some episodes.
Oh, she was.
I was on the couch or the garage, I forget. And now you have your mom about to disown you.
She was so upset with you, she put you on the roof of the garage.
No, the couch. Remember? I remember there was something. I forget one of the episodes. I don't even remember what it was.
You said you were on the garage.
I meant in.
Oh, like in the doghouse.
So did you respond? What do you feel about your mom's, no offense, Mrs. Roumeles, but...
Oh, well,
not very substantial argument.
I told her, I would not be seeing her Thanksgiving or Christmas.
Oh, of course.
For disagreeing. The second thing is, it's family stuff,
Oh, sure.
It's private. It's private.
Sure.
I disagree, mommy. I love you.
Wow.
So.
That's all.
I have to go.
Okay. Well, we're going to, the show must go on. That was a weird sound effect. Where'd you find that one?
That was on my, weird sound effects.
That's cool. You could pause the sound effect now. Stop letting it play.
Yeah, all right.
Okay, that'd be great. I don't think, it sounds like an upset person about the hot dogs.
Yeah.
The argument really isn't there, though, because, there's so many things. I don't want to nitpick the whole argument. I feel bad because it's Mrs. Roumeles, but
it's
see definition.
See the definition.
See the definition.
Mom.
Sorry. I know you don't want it to be. By the way, all those rulers she named.
Yeah.
So the category is ruler.
Yeah.
And then that's a type of ruler.
Right.
So the category is sandwiches, and a hot dog's a type of sandwich.
Yes. Yeah. And I didn't have the heart to tell her because she clothed me and fed me and sheltered me.
Okay. Well, she didn't do that for me, so.
Right.
You're wrong. With all due respect.
I don't have to.
You're a very nice woman.
I don't have to live and raise children with Mrs. Zura, so. But she's also often wrong.
Oh, yes.
So.
Yes.
There we go.
Looks like we'll be.
Boy, this is embarrassing.
Living together pretty soon because we're gonna be both kicked out of
the odd couple, am I right?
We are not that odd. Okay.
I want a restraining order.
From me or your mom?
You.
Oh. We can do that after the show.
Okay.
Before I forget.
Yeah.
The Webster word of the day.
Oh.
Where's that? You got the theme music?
All right, ready? I didn't compose it yet.
Jeez.
I know. I keep forgetting, but there's just so much to do. I mean, for God's sake, we didn't even have an episode last week. So I wasn't taking the time off to consult with, you know, famous people who sing music these days. Janis Joplin.
Webster word of the day.
Webster word of the day. I am not going to do it, actually.
No, what do you mean? We have to do it. It's a segment.
I'm not doing it. Do you want to know why?
Sure, you're going to tell me anyway, but go ahead. Why?
Well, aside from the fact that it's getting a little demanding from you that I have to create this theme song, I have a little resentment towards them because I called them up the other day and I said I'd like to make a transfer of funds, and they said they don't have my money.
Mr. Roumeles,
I said, where did my money go?
Did you call Webster's bank?
I called Webster and I asked them to transfer funds for me.
I think you might have called Webster's bank because they don't accept. That's not a thing. We're talking Webster's dictionary. Oh. Merriam-Webster, Daniel Webster.
That explains why every time I demand a dictionary from that ATM, it sort of doesn't do it. Okay, I got to stop doing that. Yeah, all right.
The Webster word of the day is nary. there's a gorilla outside the door or something.
Let's investigate.
No, let's not.
All
I'm
right.
going to finish the show before we get... nary. You know, I feel like you know this one.
Nary a stitch. Is that a nary a stitch or something to find? It means hardly. It means hardly. Oh, the old...
It means hard. Kind of.
Nary a stitch. What is that from? I think it's from some sort of.
I have no idea.
Christmas song or something. I don't know.
That's fine. Yeah, anyway. Nary basically means not one, not any. So hardly is
not
similar.
Any.
Not any. You know, there's nary a phrase we can't solve on this show.
Yeah, except we often
have technical difficulties. You're having your second Clementine on the air. This whole episode has just been. There's crumbs.
Well, you're the one who brought in Fruit Loops.
The viewers asked if they were the same. I'm just trying to cater to the
No one's
the
viewing.
All right.
They're listening.
But you view the okay. That's got to sound weird on the air.
It's
the opening
it's
of a
Clementine.
I know what it is. It's got to sound weird though.
Awesome.
All right. Well, folks.
Very
genius. Wow. We that's all the time we have for today. next week though, our next episode, the Halloween special. Got to make sure we do it in the daylight so Mr. Roumeles doesn't turn into a werewolf. I will bring garlic and...
Folks, I just want to note.
Well, hold on. Why don't you swallow before you start talking into the microphone?
I just want to note that Zura, his job is to sort of just take us out. And I'm supposed to close the show today?
Yeah.
I just turned away from the microphone and just
started
attended to peeling my Clementine. And this guy is such a professional. He doesn't miss a beat.
Right.
So
somebody's got to.
That being said.
Yeah.
We will see you next time. Who knows what we'll be eating on the air.
Surprise.
But until then, stay tuned for our Halloween episode, and we'll catch you next time. I'm Mr. Roumeles.
I'm Mr. Zura.
Thanks for listening. We'll see you next time. For the record, I don't live with my mom now.